Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to discuss about the biogas and its application. Now, the biogas, a mixture containing 65% to for 55% to the 65% of methane and 30 to 45% of carbon dioxide, and the rest being the impurities, just like hydrogen, hydrogen sulfide, and some nitrogen, can be produced from the decomposition of animal, plant, and waste, human waste. It is a clean but slow burning gas. It can be used directly in the cooking, so that the reducing the demand of firewood. The material from which the biogas is produced retains its value as a fertilizer and can be returned to the soil. The biogas is produced by the digestion, pyrolysis, and or hydrogasification. Actually, the digestion? The digestion is a biological process that occurs in the absence of the oxygen and in the presence of anaerobic organism at the ambient pressure and temperatures of the 70 or we can say 35 to the 70 degrees centigrade. The container in which the digestion takes place is known as a digester. These are the application of the biogas. That means the biogas can be used in the cooking, domestic lighting and heating, IC engines and fuel cells. That means the electricity can be produced by using the biogas in a fuel cell with air as a oxidant. The electrolyte is usually KOH, potassium hydroxide. Now the biogas plant. So main function of the biogas plant is to the biogas plant converts wet biomass into the biogas by the process of anaerobic fermentation. That means the bacteria called anaerobe carried out the digestion of the biomass without oxygen and produces methane and carbon dioxide. So biogas plants are very popular in India, particularly in rural areas. These are the raw materials used in a biogas plant for the production of biogas. That is animal waste, that is cattle dung, urine, fish waste, human waste. Waste matter, urine, agriculture waste, sugar cane trash, tobacco waste, vegetable waste, etc. And last one is the industrial waste. That means the waste raw material is sugar factory and paper factory. We can receive the raw material for the production of biogas. So these are the raw materials used in the biogas plant. They are the main components of the biogas plant: digester, gas holder, inlet, outlet, slurry mixing tank, gas outlet pipe, and distillery refinery. The first one is the digester. Digester, that means it is the container where the digestion takes place. Next one is the gas holder. So main function of the gas holder to hold the gas, and from the gas holder, the gas can be sent to the other place where it is used. And inlet, it is used for the feeding of the slurry from the mixing tank. And outlet, it is outlet, with the help of the outlet, we can receive the sludge, or we can out the sludge from the biogas plant slurry mixing tank. So this is this one is a tank for the mixing of slurry, or we can provide the for making the slurry. And the gas outlet pipe, this is connected with the gas holder. And this, if any, it is not required in all the plants, but where it is required for the mixing of the slurry proper, it is used. These are the factors affecting the size of a biogas plant. So these are the key factors, which is most important factors for affecting the size of a biogas plant. So we can say that the biogas plant is depend on these factors. The type of waste, that means which type of the waste we are using in the biogas plant, either solid waste, liquid waste, or semi-solid waste. Daily rate of waste to be digested. Digestion period, how much time is to be take for the digestion of the slurry. Method of stirring, if any. And arrangement of the raw waste feeding and discharge of the digested slurry, that is the inlet and outlet pipe is for the inlet pipe for the raw material feeding, and discharge outlet pipe for the discharge of the digested slurry, and it is also depend on the climatic conditions. So this is a most important factor, the climatic conditions. If the climatic conditions are changed, then the efficiency of the biogas plant may also be changed. Mixing of raw waste. So this is mixing tank is also provided for the mixing of raw waste, but this is one of the factor also depend on the mixing. If the proper mixing is not done, then the digestion of the biomass will not be proper. So the on the basis of the digestion, the output of the biogas plant, that is gas, is not uniform. And the type of dome, that means either a flexible dome or fixed dome or floating dome. That is generally there are the two types of the dome, that is fixed and floating dome. Now the classification of biogas plant. They are the classification. First one is the continuous type biogas plant. It is further divided into the single stage biogas plant and double stage biogas plant. Next one is the batch type biogas plant. Next, floating dome type biogas plant, fixed dome type biogas plant, and modified fixed dome type biogas plant. These are the classification of biogas plant. In the next lecture, we will discuss all these biogas plants one by one with the help of the diagram. So it is sufficient for today. Thank you. Thank you very much.